Hello students, so last class we discussed about living world and the characteristic of living world. So what is living world? The living world comprises an amazing diversity of living organism that all present day living organisms are related to each other and also to all living organisms that ever lived on this earth. Was a revelation which humbled man and led to cultural movements for conservation of biodiversity. So today we're going to deal with in this chapter a topic about binomial nomenclature is the formal naming system for living things that all scientists use. It gives every species a two-part scientific name. So it is nothing but the biological system of naming the organism in which the name is composed of two terms, that is a scientific name, where the first term indicates the genus and the second term indicates the species of the organism. Here you can see the two words, that is the genus and species naming system, are called binomial nomenclature. Okay, for example, here I used Homo sapien. Homo is genus and sapien is species. Who introduced the term binomial nomenclature? Our father of taxonomy, Carolus Linnaeus. He established the practice of binomial nomenclature, that is the denomination of each kind of plant by two words, that is genus and species. Why we use the binomial nomenclature? Because the scientific names are informative when you compare to the common name. Every recognized species on earth, at least in any one of the theory, is given a two part of scientific name. So this system is called binomial nomenclature. These names are important because they allow people throughout the world to communicate about the animal species or the plant species. There was a question in nowadays, that is binomial nomenclature still used today? Yes. The binomial nomenclature is a system of scientifically naming organism developed by Carolus Linnaeus. This work was published in the various section between 1735 and 1758 and established the convention of binomial nomenclature which are still used today by our biologists. All living species including plant, animal, birds, and also some microbes have their own scientific name. For example, the scientific name of the tiger is presented as Panthera tigris. The Panthera, the term refers and it represents the term genus. And tigris represent a particular species or specific epithet. And then one more example, the scientific name of human is presented as Homo sapien. Whereas Homo represent the genus and sapien represent a particular species. And we can see one more example, the Indian bullfrog. And the scientific term written as Rana tigrina or tigrina. Rana is the name of the genus and tigrina is the name of the species. So this way we will give the name for binomial nomenclature for the common names of the particular species. Now let us discuss the binomial nomenclature of human, that is Homo sapien, the scientific term, with the taxonomy hierarchy. So here you can see the taxonomy, which is deals with the kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. Now we're going to study the taxonomy hierarchy of human being, that is Homo sapiens. Here you can see the kingdom is animal, phylum chordates, class mammal, order primate, family hominids, genus Homo and species is sapien. So comprisingly we call that as Homo sapiens. So it is a method of giving each species a name consisting of two words. The first name is a generic name which is the name of the genus and the second name is the name of species, that is a specific name which can be given by the scientist. Genus name is written by capital letter and species name is written by small letter. Both names should be underlined or should be written in italic form. So these are the rules to follow in the taxonomy hierarchy, which is given as the binomial nomenclature. Here you can see the example. For domestic cat, Felis domesticus. Grizzly bear, Ursus orbulis. Medicinal leech, Irido medicinalis. Housefly, Mucus domestica. Here you can see the genus name, which is represented in the capital letter, and the species name, which is represented as small letter. And here you can notice the each of the binomial nomenclature names were underlined. So this will be the taxonomy hierarchy of tiger. Here you can see the kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata, class Mammalia, order Carnivora, family Felidae, genus Panthera, and species Panthera. So here you can see the scientific term as Panthera panthera. And next we see another example is common name is pebble crab, but the scientific name is Xanthias lamarckii. So here you can see the genus and species. So rules of binomial nomenclature, as we seen before. So what will be the rules? A biologist from all over the world follows a uniform set of principles for naming the organism. There are two international codes which are agreed upon by all the biologists over the entire world for the naming protocol. They are ICBN and ICZN. So nothing but ICBN is indication of the floral, and ICZN is the protocol followed for fauna. So ICBN is nothing but International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, which deals with the biological nomenclature for plants. And ICZN, International Code of Zoological Nomenclature, deals with the biological nomenclature of animals. Next, we can see the codes which makes sure that each organisms get a specific name, and that name is globally identified. So these are the scientific names, and these are the rules which are followed and accepted by globally. The naming follows certain conventions, that is, each scientific name has two parts, generic name and specific epithet. So the rules, again we will discuss. The first, the genus name should be capitalized. The species name should be do not capitalize. Okay, it should be in a small letter. Both names must be underlined or italicized. Example, human, Homo sapiens. The rest of the binomial nomenclature rules for writing the scientific names of organisms include the following. All the scientific names of organisms are usually Latin. So hence they are written in italics. These exist two parts of a name that we discussed, genus and species. When the names are handwritten, they are underlined or italized if typed. This is done for specify its Latin origin. Okay, make a note. If you're writing in handwritten, the scientific name should be underlined. If you're typing as a document, it should be italized. The name of the genus starts with a capital letter, and the name of the species starts with a small letter. Yeah, this what we see. Okay, so this will be the illustration. The first name, genus, capitalized. The second name, species, lowercase. Both names are underlined or written in italics. Okay, so this way we will use the binomial nomenclature. So please follow this instruction correctly. So only giving the instruction based on this binomial nomenclature, because this is very, very important categories to know. What will be the drawback of binomial nomenclature? So some of the basic drawbacks, see, if will be the merit, there will be also the demerit. Okay, so there will be the drawback of binomial nomenclature also. If two or more names are currently in use, according to the law of priority, the correct name will be one used first. At other end up being synonyms, our validity is the senior synonym. Providing stability in the naming and classification of organism must be emphasized. And also, the name used prior to those included in the Systema Naturae by Linnaeus are not recognized. So this will be the drawback of binomial nomenclature.